Hey everybody, welcome back to my channel. So I wanted to make this video, which I would like to make a thread and have a lot of people kind of giving their insights and opinions and personal experiences about this. So this is kind of a response to my friend Elvis is the Man's video. We were talking on Instagram. I was kind of letting him know about this person at work had said something like, "Oh wow, you're an Elvis fan." Then that's kind of weird, right? And I was like, "Well, not really, you know." And they said, "Well, how can you like Elvis? You know, he was an addict and he was just chased women and you know stuff like that, just you know nonsense stuff." Obviously, they don't know a lot about him, and they just kind of whatever the bad that they do think they know, they just jump on that, but. And it kind of brought back a lot of memories as a kid. I never really talked about Elvis much around school and stuff like that. And so I thought, you know, I was talking with him and was like, hey, you know, it's probably a good idea to make a video and hear some other people's thoughts and stuff. So just to dive right in, my personal experience is I saw Elvis and being into Elvis when no one else was growing up. I saw Elvis on TV. It was one of the 50s performances from, I believe, the Ed Sullivan Show. And kind of like a lot of people have, you know, you see him and I just thought, wow, this guy is it. This guy's got it. This is, you know, this. He looked incredible. His moves were incredible. And I became a fan instantly. I was about 6 years old. And that just progressed, you know. I went to Graceland, toured it. I went to Tupelo, toured that. It was just a great time. But going into public school, so around like second, third grade, when kids starting, I guess, realizing who Elvis was or what he was, I was already into him by that age, really, pretty young. But I started hearing a lot of comments about, oh, you like Elvis, so that fat guy, you know, just a lot of kind of hate towards him for really no reason. A lot of people didn't know that much about him, but the thing is that just the bad stuff they did know, they just labeled him of that's all he was. And every time I kind of explain it, you know, I'd say, well, no, he wasn't, you know, I kind of explain who he was as a person. And it just got really tiring, honestly, in school. So I would quit wearing some of the Elvis shirts and stuff. I was almost like, Oh, by the way, I live in Memphis, everybody. So all of the Elvis fans that are watching this, Elvis does not have hardly any place in Memphis at all for the younger crowd. The older folks, a lot of them are gone that actually respected him and liked him, but there is not a big fan base of Elvis in Memphis, period. Just wanted to let y'all know that. It's pretty sad. Anyways, so as I got older, middle school, I got into other bands like the Beatles, which are a little bit more acceptable to fans, which that was a thread a while back too, you know, being into the Beatles when no one else was. And it still got a lot of hate, you know, a lot of kids that were into like new stuff, rap, and top 40 music, they still kind of hated on it. But it wasn't, a lot of people don't know a lot about the Beatles. They just were like, oh, that music sucks. But Elvis, they didn't know the music. They just knew the bad things, you know, the supposedly bad things about him or whatever. Kind of the myths and stuff, the image, you know, not really the man himself. And so it was just an ongoing thing. But I eventually almost got to the point where I kind of just didn't ever say anything about Elvis unless someone else brought it up as a kid. And as I got older and became a teenager, that changed. I liked Elvis. I didn't really care who, you know, if they people liked what I liked or not. Same thing went for the Beatles and other bands that I like. I still didn't talk about it much in public, though, just because, you know, I mean, I didn't really post about him and stuff like that, just because a lot of people just really didn't, I figured they didn't care. And I wasn't really open about, oh, you know, I'm a big Elvis fan, too, on top of everything else I like. Until, it actually wasn't until 2017, when another one of my, someone I'm a huge fan of, Tom Petty, did this great documentary, The Searcher. Well, I liked a lot of it. Some of it was a little bit, towards, one-sided and stuff towards Priscilla and all that. But there was a lot of really good parts in it. And I loved everything Tom said. But Tom Petty said at the very beginning something I'm going to play for you right now.
God bless him. He was a light for all of us. We all owe him for going first into battle. He had no roadmap, and he forged a path of what to do and what not to do. We shouldn't make the mistake of writing off a great artist by all the clatter that came later. We should dwell in what he did that was so beautiful and everlasting, which was that great, great music.
Anyways, so that basically just summed up everything I've really ever wanted to hear and everything I needed to hear. You know, this guy was a great guy, and some of the choices he made wasn't so great, and some of the things he did was really great, and we shouldn't write off a great artist like that. And it was after I heard that, it was like, you know what? I'm gonna be, public with liking Elvis or whatever. Another thing I want to talk about in this video is that I don't want to get on a soapbox too much, but we live in a world now where there's a lot of what they call cancel culture. So you know something bad about somebody and then they're canceled, per se. And I don't agree with that. I don't think that just because, there's... Personally, I think that we're all pretty flawed human beings and that nobody's perfect, none of us are perfect, and we all have bad things about us. The only difference with Elvis is that his bad flaws were for the whole world to see. But there's a great quote from Elvis that he actually wrote in his Bible that I wanted to say to y'all, which was, to judge a man by his weakest link is like judging the power of the ocean by just one wave. So that sums up a lot. You can't just hear one bad quality about somebody and just totally write them off when they did so much good. And there's one of my favorite things about the conversation with the person at work actually came up because I work in Memphis. I meet a lot of older folks that actually knew him. And I hear amazing stories, incredible stories, about how one time, for example, this person came up and said, I owned a store, and Elvis opened up an account in my store and said that if anyone's ever struggling to pay or whatever, just put it on my account, but don't tell them it was me. Don't say anything, Just say someone's covered this for you. And that's just incredible, And the car stories about how he would see people of all different types of colors and backgrounds and very poor people and say, you like that car, it's yours. My favorite story of all is one that Sonny West actually told, which is that they read in the newspaper, the local Memphis newspaper, that there was this woman who she didn't have like any legs or anything. She had some disease or an accident. She didn't have any legs. And so she was getting around on a board. She was kind of sliding around on a board with wheels because she was very poor and she didn't have any money for a nice electric wheelchair or anything. And so they told Elvis about it, and he just went and said, let's go. And they got the best electric wheelchair, you could, and they delivered it to her house. And she was an older woman, and she kind of broke into tears and said, thank you so much. And she said, what's your name? He said, Elvis Presley. She said, thank you, Elvis, so much. You have no idea how much this means to me. And they left. And Sonny, which was Elvis's friend, for those that don't know, he said, Elvis, I don't think she had any idea I don't think she knew who you were. And he said, it doesn't matter. She knows somebody cares about her. And so just to give you, to those that don't know much about him, kind of the person he really was, that's really who he was. And he did struggle with other things, you know, but that's all, y'all can all do research on that. But yeah, I just hate always having to kind of explain my liking Elvis to people in public that don't know much about him. And honestly, I relate that a lot to, I think that has a lot to do with EPE and the fact that Elvis Presley Enterprises and the fact that they don't really do anything for his image. They really just keep, you know, putting stuff out about his image. You know, they don't really do much for his image. The last I heard that they were planning on doing a Netflix cartoon where like Elvis is some type of spy or whatever, looking like Johnny Bravo or something. You know, it's like that that just really turns people off and makes people think he was just, you know, nothing. Instead of releasing, like, that's the way it is, all this extra footage and stuff of him. You know, the who he was on stage, his incredible talent. Corner. I can't walk. Because I love it too much. We don't get much of that, sadly. And I think if we did, there would be a lot more younger fans. Anyways, I just wanted to make a video, and if, you know, this kind of resonates with you, share your story, you know, make a video. And I have a few people subscribe to my page. It's in the, what they call the music community, vinyl community. I know my friend Matt is on here, and a few other people, and I really encourage y'all. I would love to hear, you know, what was it kind of tough for you growing up as a kid liking Elvis, and did you ever get a lot of kind of crap for it growing up, and what did you do? And so yeah, anyways, that's basically all I wanted to say. And if you really want to know more about who Elvis really was, I really recommend watching movies. There's a great documentary called, it's about kind of the gospel side of Elvis, called He Touched Me. And that's a really great documentary. There's a lot of good parts in the Searcher documentary. It was on HBO. I thought was pretty good. I don't think it covered the 70s really well, but besides that, I think it was a really good documentary. But yeah, so anyways, I don't want to go on too much longer. But y'all all take care, have a great day, and TCB.